Question 23 here. So we're given a polynomial function. And here it is here. List each zero. So the zero is where the function itself is equal to zero and according to its multiplicity in the categories. Okay. So we look at, these are three numbers being multiplied. A times B times C. Okay. And they're all, we're looking for the zeros. Where does it equal zero? So each one is individually equal to zero. So A is the first number is really 6x. So when is 6x equal to zero? Well, divide both sides by 6, you get that x equals zero. Whenever x equals zero. Now this has an exponent on the x of 1. So that's got a multiplicity of 1. Okay. The next zero is x plus 7. You can see that the exponent here is also 1, 1 there, and 1 there. So we look at when is x plus 7 equal to 0. This is also going to have a multiplicity of 1, that there's 1 0. And that what that means is that when, so when x equals 0, when it crosses here, it's going to go straight through, okay, that way, or maybe the other way, but it goes straight through. That's a multiplicity of 1. Minus 7, minus 7. So also at x equals negative 7, we get a single. So if it goes up like that, it'll, you know, at negative 7, it's shooting straight through. Okay. So those are the ones that have multiplicity of 1. What we're seeing, the last 0 is going to come from x minus 5. And we notice this exponent here. That's a multiplicity of 3. Because the exponent's 3. So it's kind of like it goes through 3 times, and when it does that, what does it do? Let's solve it first. We'll see that that's going to happen at positive 5, because you add 5 to both sides, x equals 5. So we get another 0 there. And what it does is it kind of does an S-curve through, so it kind of does something like that. It's hard to tell. It doesn't go straight through, it does that curve. And just, they don't have it, but if it had a multiplicity of 2, the multiplicity of 2, it does what I call kisses the x-axis. It just touches and bounces off. So that's a multiplicity of 2. We don't have any of those because we don't have anything with an exponent of 2. So how do we fill this out? We come here, multiplicity of 1. We've got 2 of them. So let's go ahead and get 2 of them ready. One happens when x is 0, that's this one here, and the other happens when x is negative 7. Now, we don't have to worry about order, you could have done it either way. Multiplicity of 2, there are none of those. Okay, and a multiplicity of 3, we see this one, and it's x equals 5, not negative 5. Notice there's a minus 5 here, but you have to solve it for 0, so you always end up with the opposite signs. So positive 5. Those are our zeros. Thanks.